Hello friends, welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today, and I hope you're all having a great time. SpaceX is testing a new way to communicate with spacecraft that are coming back to Earth from orbit. Usually when a spacecraft re-enters the atmosphere, it loses contact with the ground because of a plasma layer that forms around it. This plasma blocks radio signals and makes it hard to monitor the spacecraft's status and location. But SpaceX thinks it can solve this problem by using its Starlink satellites, which are orbiting the Earth and providing internet access. SpaceX plans to use the Starlink network to relay signals from the spacecraft to the ground, bypassing the plasma layer. This way, SpaceX hopes to maintain continuous communication with the spacecraft during re-entry. SpaceX will test this idea with its Crew Dragon capsule, which carries astronauts to and from the International Space Station. The next Crew Dragon mission, called Crew 9, is scheduled to launch in October 2024 and return in April 2025. SpaceX will use one of its Starlink satellites to communicate with the Crew Dragon capsule as it re-enters the atmosphere and lands in the Atlantic Ocean. If successful, this technique could improve the safety and reliability of spacecraft re-entry, as well as enable new applications such as hypersonic vehicles that fly faster than the speed of sound. SpaceX is not the only company working on this challenge. NASA and Lockheed Martin are also developing systems to overcome the communications blackout during re-entry. On the other hand, Elon Musk made a big announcement recently. He said he wants to move 1 million people to Mars. This is part of his plan to make sure humanity survives. He thinks it's important because if something bad happens on Earth and we can't send supplies to Mars anymore, people there should still be okay. Musk talked about Starship. He said it's going to take people to Mars. He even compared going to Mars in the future to taking a flight across the country. It shows he's serious about making space travel more common. He also mentioned that Starship could reach the moon in less than 5 years. And he's planning for SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft to go farther from Earth than any humans have in a long time. But Musk isn't just thinking about Mars. He believes humans should also have a base on the moon. He thinks we should have cities on Mars and explore beyond our own solar system. He said it's important for humanity to have a moon base where people can live permanently. This way we can use it as a launching point to go to Mars and beyond. Musk also wants to make sure Starship works well. He hopes that the third test flight this year will prove that it can safely go to orbit and come back down. The Federal Aviation Administration recently mentioned that SpaceX still needs to fulfill certain paperwork requirements before they can get the green light for their third test. Despite this bureaucratic hurdle, SpaceX is forging ahead. They've shared images of their new rockets, signaling another step in their mission to create the first interplanetary transport system. The military sees a different use for Starship. They think it could be a fast way to move things around the world. They could send supplies or even troops anywhere in less than an hour. They've been thinking about this for a long time, and now it's becoming real. They're already figuring out how to fit things into Starship's cargo bay. One big reason the military likes Starship is because it's fast, but it's also getting cheaper. SpaceX's other rockets, like Falcon 9, have brought down the cost of sending things to space a lot. Starship will make it even cheaper. They're aiming to start at $90 per pound, which is similar to using big cargo planes. SpaceX plans to launch Starship many times each year, maybe even thousands of times. They're building more launch sites to handle all the launches. This could help the military send things quickly to different parts of the world. China is also working on similar rockets. They're trying to catch up with the US in space technology. They're building more launch sites and making their rockets reusable too. China wants to have a space station and land people on the moon. The military sees this as important because they want to keep the Indo-Pacific region open and free. They think having fast transportation can help with that. It could also help in a war situation. People involved in space technology believe Starship will succeed eventually. They're hoping for successful tests soon because it'll help move things forward in space exploration and military uses. On the other hand, United Launch Alliance, or ULA, is about to undergo a big change. The company might be sold soon. This news has stirred up a lot of talk, especially because the buyer will have to compete with the biggest player in the space business, SpaceX. Last year, there was a lot of talk about Boeing and Lockheed Martin, the companies that own ULA, possibly leaving the rocket business. This caused a big stir. Then ULA's CEO, Tory Bruno, gave a presentation that looked like it was about ULA being bought by another company. There are a few potential buyers interested in ULA. One of them is Blue Origin, which is owned by Jeff Bezos, the same person who started Amazon. Another potential buyer is Cerberus, a big investment company. And then there's Textron, which is an aerospace company. But despite these potential buyers, there hasn't been much news about any offers or deals. ULA has been valued at about $2 billion for a long time. Some experts think it's a good idea for ULA to be sold because SpaceX, another rocket company, has become very successful, especially with the US military. But even though ULA's value has been around $2 billion, its owners initially wanted more than $4 billion for it. Now, experts think a fair price would be between $2 billion and $2.5 billion. Textron is interested in buying ULA because it wants to grow its business. But some experts think this might not be a good idea because getting into the space business is risky. However, Textron also tried to buy another company that makes rocket engines, so buying ULA would be a big deal for them. Blue Origin is also interested in buying ULA. They already worked together on some projects, but Blue Origin mostly focuses on its own rockets. Still, if Blue Origin buys ULA, it could help both companies grow and work together more closely. Cerberus seems like the most likely buyer for ULA. They have a lot of money and experience working with government and national security businesses. They're also good at buying companies and making them better. But some experts aren't sure if Cerberus buying ULA will be enough to compete with SpaceX, especially with SpaceX's new rocket, the Starship. Some experts think there might be a surprise buyer for ULA. They say that because there hasn't been much news about ULA since they launched their new rocket, the Vulcan. They think that if someone wants to buy ULA, they should have made an offer by now. So the future of ULA is still uncertain, but whoever buys it will have a big challenge competing with SpaceX, the biggest player in the space business right now. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.